Now, dozens of flood warnings are in place across New South Wales as 8 different rivers overflow in rural parts of the state. The rising waters have forced more evacuations and cut off some towns entirely. SES Chief Superintendent Sonia Oyston joins us now with all the latest. Superintendent, thank you for your time today. What areas are you most worried about right now?
Well, good morning, Tristan and Sarah. We are seeing that long flooding across southern and western New South Wales. At the moment, we are still very focused on the Lachlan River and the towns there.
Chief Superintendent, if locals are isolated and roads are cut off, how can they access help or supplies? What are you telling people?
So over this year, we've actually had a lot of communities isolated in southern and western New South Wales with this campaign flooding. At one point, we were actually resupplying an area the size of Switzerland. So it has been a huge effort from New South Wales SES. What we are asking communities to do, if you do need help, to ring 132 500 and to visit our website for all the warnings and information in place. And of course, if it is an emergency, ring 000.
Great. Helicopters, they've been used to evacuate Yuapalong residents. Have you managed to get everyone to safety?
The people on the ground are absolutely working with the communities to evacuate those areas, especially around Yuapalong at the moment. So we are asking communities to go to the Royal Hotel for the evacuation point, and we are working through that at the moment.
And in the small town of Moulamein, 85% of residents there, they've chosen to stay to protect their town. These communities, they're so strong. They're incredible in the face of all of this water. What's keeping them together, do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, these communities have gone through drought and now flooding, so they do have resilience with them and they do have that strong community bond. New South Wales SES do not issue out warnings lightly. So when we do ask for those communities to listen to those and adhere to those.
International help from places like New Zealand and Singapore, they've flown in. What do they make of the scale of this disaster?
Look, we have been so busy over this last year. We've utilised our emergency partners within New South Wales and also within interstate. And now we are so grateful to have international support from Singapore and New Zealand. They have come in and they're out in those areas of need and they have fit right in, and the bond that they're building between the countries and also those local communities has been amazing. So we're very, very grateful for the support that they're providing.
We know that workers like the SES have been doing a fantastic job, a hard job all year. And we've heard that these SES operations will go into February now. How long will the immediate flood emergency actually last for?
Well, we need the water to go down the river. So, they're making their way down there. But with La Nina still around and the water still continuing to fall in those already wet catchment areas, we are looking for that extended emergency response out until February and potentially even longer. So it really depends on the weather and where it falls.
Chief Superintendent Sonia Oyston, thank you so much for all your help. Thanks for your time today and make sure you stay safe.
Great, thank you.
Thank you. And if you need SES assistance, call 132 500, or if it's life-threatening, dial 000.